Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure Syncfusion Vue Tree Grid using the Vue CLI command and the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Tree Grid package. You can use the Vue Tree Grid to visualize self-referential, hierarchical data effectively in a tabular format. I will show you how to configure this control, along with a few of its basic features like binding data, customizing columns, and enabling paging, sorting, and filtering. Let me show you the application creation process. I'm going to create my application using the Vue CLI toolchain. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue, Node, and Vue class component. In the command prompt, I run the command npm install global Vue CLI. Then I create a new project using the Vue create command and provide the app name, my Vue project. I navigate to the desired location and install the Vue class component library and specify the version. Then install the tree grid package using the npm install syncfusion ej2 Vue tree grid command. I open the project in VS Code and navigate to the app.vue page and import the tree grid component from the syncfusion ej2 Vue tree grid package and register this component plugin to the Vue. By doing this, all the component's child directives are also globally registered. Then I add the EJS tree grid tag to the template section. Then import the material theme styles into the style section to apply CSS styles to the tree grid component. Next, the Syncfusion license key must be registered. Open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Vue trial license. From 2022 Volume 1 release, license key is mandatory in Vue projects to avoid the license warning. To view the basic layout of a tree grid, you need to bind a data source. I add the file data.js and define the hierarchical object sample data. Look at this data, it contains tasks and subtasks. For the first object, I have added the fields, task ID, task name, and so on, with appropriate values. I also add the child object, with the same fields. Then I import this sample data from the data.js file, and in the data method, assign this object to the variable data, and assign this variable to the data source property. I need to map the child records using the child mapping property. Here, I map the subtasks data source field. Set the tree column index property to 1 to have an expand button in the first column. Let me run this example using the command npm run serve and show you the output. Check now, the tree grid is rendered with hierarchical data. I can collapse and expand the parent task. Look here, the column names are displayed as it is in the data source field names. You can customize the field name and display only selected columns using columns directive and column directive. Import the columns directive and column directive from the tree grid package and register them with ecolumns and ecolumn tag. I add the ecolumns tag to specify the details for a list of columns. Then add the ecolumn tag to customize a single column. There are more options available to customize the tree grid columns, but I will show you a few now. I include the field property and map the task ID field from the data source. Include the header text property and set its value to task ID. Customize the default column width using the width property and align the column data by setting the text align property to right. In the same way, I define other fields. Apply the date format to the column start date by setting the format property to YMD. Apply same format to the end date column. See now, each column displays a custom header. The task ID column data is right aligned, and date format is applied to the start and end date columns. Next, I will show you how to enable the few basic features. Before moving to this, you need to understand the feature module concept of the tree grid. To make this component lightweight, its features are available in modules, and just the required ones can be used. I have linked the document that contains the complete list of feature modules in the below description, and I will show a few of them now. First, I will start with paging feature. To use pager, I import the page module from the tree grid package and inject it in the tree grid array of the provide object. To enable a paged view, set the allow paging property to true. Check the tree grid, the pager is rendered. Now, I will show you how to enable sorting. I import the sort module from the EJ2 tree grid package. Then inject the sort module in the tree grid array of the provide object. I set the allow sorting property to true. Check the tree grid, when I click the column header, data is sorted in either ascending or descending order. Finally, I will show you how to enable filtering. I import the filter module from the EJ2 tree grid package and inject the filter module in the tree grid component. I set the allow filtering property to true. Check the tree grid, the filter box is shown, and I can type any text to filter the tree grid records. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Vue Tree Grid component using the Vue CLI command and a few of its basic features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.